Good morning. I'm Berks County Commissioner Christian Leinbach, and I want to welcome you to our Commissioners Board meeting for June the 6th, also D-Day, probably one of the most significant events of World War II, definitely within the European theater. We're broadcasting today live via Microsoft Teams live event. BCTV is recording, but will be running the program later in the week. We're also on Facebook and YouTube Live. At this time, we'll begin with a moment of silence, followed by a pledge to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Are there any additions or corrections for the June 1st, 2023 meeting minutes? Hearing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. We did have an executive session yesterday. I dealt with personnel litigation. There were actually two different ones and another one on personnel. And then June the 1st also dealing with personnel. At this time, I'll recognize my executive assistant, Anne-Marie Grill, to read the public comment policy.
Thank you, Commissioner Leinbach. Public comment will be accepted in person and through the Q&A function. Please include your first name, last name, and municipality for all comments. Any comments without name and municipality will not be considered. Each citizen can submit one comment. Comment length is dictated by limitations of the platform being used, Teams Q&A, Facebook, YouTube. In-person comments will be accepted first, followed by comments submitted virtually. The meeting comment period is limited to a total of 30 minutes, including both in-person and virtual comments. This time period may be extended at the discretion of the board. Please be concise. Comments that are germane to county business will be read during the meeting and should not be considered to be interactive dialogue with the commissioners. The county solicitor shall be the final arbiter of whether a comment is germane and should be read. Any commissioner response to public comment will be done at the discretion of the commissioners.
There's no public comment on agenda items in person or online, so we will move forward with the agenda. Item one, authorizing under that budget department. Adopt a resolution authorizing 2023 appropriations in the amount of $2,810,576 per listing dated June the 1st of 2023. There's one item listed under human resources. Authorize the appointment of Carly Nicewender to client services coordinator in the public defender's office. There's one item listed under me. Adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment of Wanda Colon, Reading, PA, to the Reading Area Community College Board of Trustees for a six-year term expiring on June 30th of 2029. Two items listed under Commissioner Sahelnick. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment of Gary Reitmeyer, Reading, PA, to the Reading Area Community College Board of Trustees for a six-year term expiring on June 30th of 2029. And item B, adopt a resolution authorizing the reappointment of Sammy A. Alley, Wyomissing, PA, to the Reading Area Community College Board of Trustees for a six-year term expiring on June 30th of 2029. There are several items listed under the commissioners. Item A, adopt a resolution authorizing Kevin S. Barnhart, Chief Operations Officer, to execute and deliver the lease agreement known as lease contract number and the numbers there for leasehold and interest in property at the Berks County Agricultural Center. This is between the United States Department of Agriculture and the County of Berks for a term of 20 years. I just want to note, this has been about 7 years in the making. Dealing with the federal government can be a challenge at times. I think this is the third round, if not more, fourth round. We have Paul Bradshaw here. He's been in it up to his neck from the beginning of an attempt to find other space, rental space, for the FSA, Farm Service Agency, and NRCS, which are two USDA programs with the federal government. They've been at the Ag Center as long as anyone can remember, and I'm glad that they're finally confirmed they're not leaving. But I'd love to know the cost that the federal government and even the county spent going back and forth over pretty much 7 years to get to where we are today, which is they're staying. So anyhow, we're glad to have them. And I can tell you, I talked to folks from our ag department yesterday and from the conservation district. They were also very thrilled that they are remaining there at the Ag Center. Item B, adopt a resolution authorizing Christine M. Sadler, County Solicitor, to execute the retainer letter with Barley Snyder, LLP, to perform legal work and training on behalf of the County of Berks as assigned by the County Solicitor. Item C, adopt a resolution declaring an emergency concerning the damages to the Grissomers Covered Bridge in Olney Township, Pennsylvania, on May 29th, 2023, resulting in the closure of the Springsville Road at the bridge, and further authorizing Kevin S. Barnhart, Chief Operations Officer, and Larry Medaglia Jr., Deputy Chief Operations Officer, to execute the permit applications and contract documents necessary to conduct the required repairs to reopen the bridge to vehicular traffic at the earliest possible time, at a cost not to exceed $250,000. This is covered by insurance, but I believe the first $50,000 is at the expense of the county. I think I'm correct on that.
Yes.
Bob. Yeah. Make sure the mic's on. Bob Patrizio, our chief financial officer.
Yeah. So this bridge, for some reason, wasn't covered by our insurance, but it is as of June 1st. So, but the person who hit the bridge has insurance, and our insurance company is going to go after them to recover 100% of this cost, which they're confident we're going to be able to get. But as far as funding it, we're going to fund it. We have to fund it first. It's going to come out of our Act 89 money.
Okay.
That is not just the $5 permit fee. There's right. also an allocation each year based on square footage of your decking mm-hmm. for every bridge that comes from a federal excise tax distribution. So it's not really costing, there's not going to be a $50,000 cost to the general fund. It's going to be, even if there was, we'd cover it out of Act 89, but we expect to get 100% reimbursed. So should turn out it doesn't cost us anything.
Very good. Thank you for jumping in, Bob. That's good information. The taxpayers, thank you. Item D, adopt a resolution authorizing the Berks County Chief Operations Officer and, in their absence, the Deputy Chief Operations Officer to enact and rescind via resolutions temporary countywide burn bans or outdoor burning bans pursuant to the procedure and requirements set forth in 16 PS subsection 13201 and 1995 Act 52, and with the concurrence of the Berks County Director of Emergency Services. We are not at this point putting one in place. If people are remember a couple of months ago, we cannot put a burn ban in place unilaterally. It requires a recommendation from DCNR's district forester asking or calling for a burn ban, and it also requires a certain percentage of fire chiefs in Berks County to call on the county to put a burn ban in place. I do want to let you know that any municipality has the ability on their own to put a burn ban in place in their municipality. This is something we're watching very closely. The conditions, I think everyone's pretty aware, are extremely dry. but neither of those requirements have occurred. So we don't have a call from the district forester, and we don't have the percentage of fire chiefs calling for a burn ban. However, we can't continue much longer like we are without that probably happening. And this allows the county to respond quickly to put the burn ban in place. And also quickly, if we have a day or two of heavy rain, we don't have to wait for the next commissioner's meeting in order to lift that burn ban. Item E, adopt a resolution authorizing Brandy Nider, Children and Youth Services Administrator, to execute the 4E protocol for Berks County Children and Youth Services and Berks County Domestic Relations, committing to a written protocol regarding the handling of Title 4E cases. Item two, a motion to authorize execution of contract agreements and amendments as set forth on the contract agenda listing. It's dated June the 1st of 2023. There are 11 contracts, two with Children and Youth Services, four with the commissioners, two with Information Systems, one with the Berks County Jail, one with Juvenile Probation, and one with the Berks County Library System. Item three, a motion to authorize execution of the payments and electronic transfers for the week ending June 8th of 2023, subject to final review and approval of the Chief Operations Officer. Item four, motion to authorize execution of payments and electronic transfers for the week ending June 15th of 2023, subject to the final review and approval of the Chief Operations Officer. And item five, motion to authorize execution of employee payroll disbursements dated June 20th of 2023, subject to the final review and approval of the Chief Operations Officer.
Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
I will second that motion. The motion has been made and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion carries. With that, we will move to reports of our treasurer and county controller. We will begin with our acting treasurer, Socrates Georgiadis. You're muted, Soc.
How's that?
There you go. You're good.
Good. Good morning. We have an opening balance of $291,142,253.51, with a balance to clear of $3,220,470.39, leaving us with a balance of $287,921,783.12.
Thank you very much, Soc.
Thank you.
We'll move now to our county controller. And I don't know who we have here. I don't see Sandy Graffius. Do we have somebody on for the county controller? We will skip the county controller's report. Let me just check my email in case she sent me an email. Grozna, I see that you're on. Are you prepared to give the controller's report?
Yes, Commissioner, good morning. I am on, but I don't have any numbers. We did not, because Oracle was down, we were not able to process the checks to the vendor. So I guess we'll have to skip that.
Not a problem. So what she was saying, Oracle is the financial system, and apparently it was down, I think, today.
For upgrades. Actually, it was down for almost a week.
Okay.
And it was down today.
For an upgrade.
Still having, yes.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. We'll look forward to the report the next time. With that, we'll move to our Chief Operations Officer, Kevin Barnhart.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. On behalf of the COO team, we also would like to commend Paul Bradshaw for his 7 years of trial and error with the USDA. We became part of this in this part of the year, and just amazing amount of time expended going back and forth and back and forth for these leases. But congratulations, 7 years to get 20, I guess. I don't know how that works. But and also, Bob, also on the Grissomers Bridge, the actions of Rex Levengood and the facilities and operations team, McCormick Taylor, our engineer, as well as the budget department, really coming together on this bridge and making things happen very quickly. It is a used covered bridge. Mm-hmm. So really, the sooner we can get that reopened to vehicular traffic, the better. So thank you to everybody involved. Appreciate it.
Very good. Thank you. With that, we will move now to commissioners' comments, beginning with Commissioner Michael Rivera.
Yes, thank you, Commissioner Linebach. A few comments here. One, the World War II event, if you were able to go this past weekend, was a great event. We had the opportunity to be in the parade from the Reading Regional Airport here into downtown Reading. The last time they did that was in 2019. So I'm glad they did it this year again. I think it was a great opportunity to have all the Jeeps and trucks and motorcycles and cars come in, came up. What did you come up with? We came up, and anyway, we came down
Penn Street. We came up and then we came down.
Yes, I'm trying to think what street we came up.
We came, we actually came in 61.
183,
and then down Penn Street to Fifth, and Penn for the first Friday event.
So anyway, we came up, we came down Penn Street, stopped there at Fifth and Penn Street, had a small ceremony. The people dressed in their World War II attire got out, walked around, went into the Ugly Oyster there, and had a good time in there, and then headed back at 1:30 to the Reading Regional Airport. So for those of you who were able to make it, it was a great event. The event continued at the Reading Regional Airport Friday, Saturday, and Sunday through 5 o'clock. I had the opportunity to go with my family on Sunday. Saw the parachuters jumping out in the afternoon. The two planes went by, 7 parachuters jumped out of each plane. So really, really great show here. Great opportunity here for Berks County and the Reading Regional Airport. It attracted people from all over the United States. So I'm glad we had good weather for that and good attendance. The other event on Friday was the Reading's First Friday event at Goggleworks. And there was also other events going on there for Goggleworks. So there's a lot going on at Goggleworks on Friday. They had a DJ, they had food, they had different exhibits going on. And also something that Goggleworks did was throughout the year, they had done different events throughout the city, and they had people write on a piece of paper what their fears were, what they were afraid of. And on Friday, there were, I think, maybe about 8 or 10 of us who had the opportunity to read 3 to 4 of those fears, read them there at the Goggleworks. Levi did a great job there. The people at the Goggleworks did a huge hammer. I don't know if you're able to see it on Facebook, but the hammer might have been maybe 6 or 7 feet tall. They made it right there at Goggleworks. And there was a jar, a glass jar filled with the comments that the people had written about their fears. And it was the hammer, it was called the Hammer of Hope. And basically that hammer, they pulled it back, they let it swing and hit the jar. The jar shattered in many pieces in representation of shattering people's fears and bringing hope to the city of Reading and to Berks County. So it's a great opportunity we had there to be able to speak about the fears that different people have and to be able to shatter that jar and talk about hope, hope for the city, hope for the county, and hope for life. So a really, really great event. Tonight is the Mental Health Developmental Disabilities Strike Out the Stigma Night at the Reading Fighting Fields. Commissioner Linebach and I will be there. We'll have the first pitches, so hopefully mine will at least make it to the catcher's mitt. Not sure how fast it will go, but hopefully it'll at least make it to the catcher's mitt tonight. But we're looking for a great game there. Strike out the stigma. For me, it's something that's very important because we have to understand many people have mental health issues, And many people are afraid, especially in the Latino community. There's a huge stigma around mental health, and it's something you don't share. You don't let other people know if your kid has it. Oh, you know, don't talk about that. And that's something we have to get rid of. We have to get rid of that stigma and understand that mental health issues is something that many people suffer with, and it needs the attention, just like any other physical issue that you would have that you need to see a doctor and get help for. Same thing as with mental health issues. So please help strike out the stigma of mental health. Also tomorrow, Commissioner Leinbach and I are leaving for the County Commissioners Association of Pennsylvania quarterly board meeting. It's in Venango County. That's why we're having our board meeting today. And one last item is next Thursday, there will be no board meeting. The next board meeting will be on June the 22nd. And that's all I have. Back to you.
Thank you very much, Commissioner Rivera. I have one item I want to share. I'm going to try to share my screen. World War II weekend. Let's see if this works. It does. So I was there on Friday and Saturday. This is actually an image from Saturday evening. I got there about 6:30 and it was pouring rain. So actually when I took this picture, everyone moved inside to get ready for the dance band. But by the time we got to 7 o'clock, and this was just practice, this is Swing Fever. Berks County actually has two big bands. A lot of people play them both. But we had Let's Dance on Friday night and Swing Fever on Saturday. You can see a lot of the reenactors. The reenactors really get into this in a big way. Primarily, you see American and German, but there's a fair number of British, Filipino. For the first time I remember, I saw free Chinese. These would have been the military under General Chiang Kai-shek in World War II. Just kind of give you an idea of the crowd. This is before we actually began. I was up on the platform taking a number of these pictures. And the other thing that stood out to me this year are the number of young people that are participating. I mean, that's the future. A lot of times you look at an event like World War II, and I can tell you initially, a lot of the people that are behind this event had ties to parents and grandparents that were involved in World War II. Unfortunately, I don't know how many years, but maybe in the next 5+ years, we are going to be talking about the last of the World War II veterans passing. And the future of World War II weekend and remembering comes to the youth. And the number of young people involved in this is pretty incredible, even little kids, as you can see in that picture. So just wanted to share a number of the pictures. And I'll end with this. that, I'll stop sharing. It was a great weekend. My understanding is they had a tremendous turnout on Saturday. You were there on Sunday, so you were able to see a little bit better. Just really great to be able to have this as part of our community. With that, we'll go to row officers' comments. Any comments from our row officers? Hearing none, there's no public comment in person. And Christine?
There is one public comment online. It's from Maria from Oley Township. Is that correct that you had received 6 million federal taxpayers' money for Passenger Railroad? To clarify, the one that connects Berks County to Montgomery County, et cetera.
Yeah, I don't know what she's talking about. I think she has multiple things confused. We've not received any new money that I'm aware of, and the total that was received or awarded last year was $750,000. That was through Muser's office, Houlihan's office, and Senator Casey's office. Maybe if she supplies an article or where her information is coming from, we can address it more specifically, but I'm not sure where she's getting her information. So I don't know. Does anyone else have anything?
No idea.
Yep. Okay. That concludes public comment. Anything for the good of the order?
Motion to adjourn.
The meeting stands adjourned.